Ola Balogun, qui est un cinéaste nigérien très, très, très connu, m'a dit, je vais t'amener derrière où se trouve Fela. Il m'a regardé, il m'a dit, hello. Je l'ai aimé, il m'a aimé. C'est comme ça que j'ai rencontré Fela.
For the first 5 years of me and Fela, Fela doesn't smoke anything. He doesn't smoke cigarette, he doesn't drink, not too.
I said, you know, there's so many important things and issues in the world that we need to sing about. Why would you sing about soup?
They take our people and spoil our towns.
And he said, when I finished reading Malcolm X, autobiography which you gave, and that book impacted on him so heavily, he told me he started to weep.
Things started developing, ideologies started to rise up, you know, things, the music start having a strong lyrics. It's not the same guy of 5 years ago.
The same man.
Why black men they suffer today?
Today in Nigeria, a lot more people are now relating to what Fela said like 40 years ago. When they listen to Fela's song, some people are wondering like, was it sung this year?
Fela was such an extraordinary figure within the Pan-African movement, the Negritude movement, the movement of black rights. He's a ghetto hero.
My society is underdeveloping because an alien system on our people. As far as Africa is concerned, music cannot be for enjoyment. Music has to be for revolution.
Fela était le seul à dénoncer ça publiquement.
George, now officer.
Ici, les juges sont des militaires. Les avocats, des militaires. La police, des militaires.
Fela vit dans nos ghettos.
Avec les gens.
Oui, avec les gens.
Hey, Fela, you say, don't talk the truth again.
And I tell them, I say, the truth. I never die.